Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to the channel. We are here today to do another episode of PSVR Showcase, my weekly show in which we look in at all the upcoming PSVR and PSVR 2 games. Today I want to do something different for a moment. Usually I like to concentrate on 100% confirmed games, but I want to talk a bit about NERF Ultimate Championship. Because, of course, this game as of now is announced only for MetaQuest 2, but that doesn't mean that it's not coming to other platforms. In February this year, the developer said, as of now it's Quest 2, but they're not ruling out releasing on Valve Index and other platforms as well, which to me means it will probably happen. And they basically been replying to a question regarding the finger tracking. And of course, Index got finger tracking, PSVR 2 itself gonna have built-in finger touch detection. And also, game of this caliber, you know, online shooter, I don't see why the developer wouldn't like to expand the player base. And it looks like it's one of those things what they basically don't want to talk about just yet. But they probably will in the future. They concentrating on the Quest version at the moment. What they doing beta. I think they've done one beta, they're gonna do second beta. Only official info is Quest 2, but also from their Twitter they saying they might be expanding to other platforms. So just wanted to pass it on, because you know what? NERF is fun. And it's gonna be even funnier, well, better in virtual reality on PlayStation VR 2. Okay, another game is called The Chullers. Now, I spoke about it before on the channel, but this is this kind of, let's say, cinematic trailer for the game. I showed you some gameplay before, probably like a year ago, but this is a, well, let's say, co-op tower defense game, maybe? Let's call it like that. So what's happening is you defending the things, but not alone, together with friends, because this game supporting a co-op, and of course you're defending it from big bugged monsters what comes to destroy it, and it's announced for PSVR, PCVR and Meta Quest. Another title that coming to PlayStation VR is Tale of Onogoro, coming from the same studio that brought you Last Labyrinth. A bit different, more action-packed and maybe less dark adventure. Originally released for Quest, but the developer said it's coming to PSVR as well. Okay, and now here we have it, another PlayStation VR 2 title. This is Blacktop Hoops, maybe for some fans of NBA Jam back in the day. This kind of my ring a bell, it looks quite interesting, this game. It's out already, I think, as a on Quest, as an alpha or beta, I don't know, or maybe they even released it fully, no idea. But anyway, a very well received title, and what the developer said, they went online and went to the PlayStation VR subreddit, and down there they announced that Blacktop Hoops will be coming to PlayStation VR 2, so now probably PSVR could run it. My best guess is you need good tracking and good controller for a basketball game of this caliber, which is like a proper, you know, gameplay when you proper playing it. Nothing like those simplistic experiences what we've had when you just throw a ball and stuff like that. This is a full-on sports title for virtual reality that many players already enjoyed and already love, which shows that this is gonna be a solid release for PlayStation VR 2, so very, very nice announcements. Stay tuned to the channel. Once I got some PSVR footage, I will be showing you here in the showcase. Now, let's move to another game, a game that got announced ages ago and a game that still didn't released, but also a game that never got cancelled. I'm talking here about Speedy Goon Savage. This is, well, it started as on rail shooter, but I think on PC they already released update when you kind of can move around a bit. You are this space person doing some contracts in space and killing some space creatures. Very nice art style, awesome weapons, very good looking game, but so far PSVR version is, well, saying delayed, I would say mega delayed. The developer never said they're not gonna do PSVR version, unless maybe they quietly moved on towards the PSVR 2 version. I don't know, I have no idea, but like I said, it was announced, it's never got cancelled, so probably it will happen in one way or another, be it in this generation of VR or on the next generation PlayStation VR 2, I don't know. But as of now, only official announcement we've got is that it's coming to PSVR 1. Now, let's move on to PSVR 2. I want to show you some gameplay, a bit of like a experimental gameplay from the developer where he's working on slicing enemies in half. And I'm talking here about Samurai Slaughterhouse. So this is coming to PlayStation VR 2. Of course, graphically looking nice, very original art style, but also nothing too demanding. My best guess is just like with Blacktop Hoops, the developer probably wants to have better tracking. And also, because there's kind of a lot of moving around and traversing through the levels, they probably want to have thumbsticks as well. What I like about this game is not only the, you know, the brainless slashing of the opponents, but also there is a quest system. So you go in and doing quests and progressing like that. Something what not, you know, most of the physically based combat games in VR, they arena based. So I like that this one is quest based. So, you know, you got at least some bit of story, bit of progression and stuff like that. So yeah, looks very, very interesting. Looking forward to play that one. I played very, very early version on the PC and I enjoyed it a lot. It's a very fun game. Okay, that's it for today. Let me know which games you are the most excited for. And of course, before I go, big shout out to all the patrons. You are all awesome. And that's it, bye.